When I started the work, I thought that trauma is something very exceptional. Only few people do have it, and it's severe. And somebody, if somebody's traumatized, my God, poor people. Meanwhile, I know that most of us are traumatized, more or less, in one or the other way. And we not only suffer from one trauma, one single event, one trauma, but just we suffer from a trauma dryas. Dryas mean three things. And these three things, in a way, fit together and have different consequences. The first and the basic thing is, what we have already talked before, is not being wanted. It's not wanted that you exist. It's not wanted that you are there. It means your parents do not want that you exist at all. The second thing is not beloved. Love for human beings is existential. For the baby, love is existential in two ways. The one way is the baby wants love. The baby wants to be loved, yeah? To receive the love, to be welcomed, to be seen, whatever. No, the symbiotic needs, love is that what the symbiotic needs show us. If you feel love, your symbiotic needs are fulfilled. And the other side of the baby wants to have a subject to love, that wants the mother to accept the love. It needs a mother that takes the love of the baby. And later on, the father and the siblings, whoever. Yeah? There is a need to be loved, and there is a need to love, to have somebody to love. For us as human beings, this is existential. And if you lose the contact with this both sides of love, then you're traumatized. And the second thing of the trauma triads is not being protected. Yeah? A baby that is not wanted, a person that is not wanted, a person that is not loved, that mostly it's also not being protected. Not being protected from attacks from outside to the body, to the psyche. You are not there's no one that defends you from perpetrators, physical perpetrators and psychological perpetrators. And this is, maybe I finish it for the break and continue after the break with the introduction. And this is the basis of what I called, meanwhile, the psychotrauma biography. Most of us live, since the very beginning, in a trauma biography. And this trauma biography starts with something what I call the trauma of identity. The trauma of not being able to be I. The trauma of not being able to be the person you are. To refer to yourself, to your want, to your needs, to your ideas. It's not allowed. It should not be. You should not be. And this is the trauma of identity. Oh, sorry. And every one of us that starts and has to start with the trauma of identity inevitably ends up in a trauma of love. That means you give up yourself and you adopt. You adopt your environment. You adopt the person in your environment. That means you adopt your mother firsthand. And you identify you with your mother. You identify with her needs, what she wants from you. And you think, the more I fulfill her needs, the more I'm similar like her, the more I am her, the more she will love me. This is the way that she loves me. But this is an illusion. It never happens. It will never happen. But you can't give up this illusion. As long as you're in a state of the trauma of identity, of love, you can't give up this illusion. I see many people that until the end of when the parents are ill, they see, oh, this is the last chance. Maybe And when they, before they die, maybe I get from them, they look at me and say, okay, I love you. They hope until the end. And even if the parents are dead, after death, they have the idea, oh, in a way, I have to work on that, that I got a good relationship with my dead parents. How can I do it? How can I keep them in my memory that I do have a good relationship with my parents? It never ends. The drama of love never ends, believe me. As much as you try, as much as you do, as much as you try to change you, do something inside, it will never end. The drama of love is a never-ending story. Out of the drama of love, there is a high tendency to offer your sexuality in order to be loved. To use sexuality, to abuse sexuality for the purpose of love. If I offer my sexuality, maybe this person loves me. Whenever I do trainings, and one module of my training is sexuality, and we start in the beginning, how do you feel with sexuality? What is about your sexuality? This is the question in the beginning. And many say, I couldn't distinguish, until in my life, I couldn't distinguish between sex and love. It was the same. I feel it as if it's the same. Yeah? So because there is so much trauma of identity, because there's so much trauma of love, there's so much trauma of sexuality. In childhood and in adulthood. It doesn't end. It starts with childhood. It starts with child traumatization. And it continues in the couple relationships, and it continues in those spheres where there's prostitution, pornography, and all sorts of violence, for example, in war times. The trauma of sexuality is common in a society that is traumatized. The top of the pyramid of the trauma biography is what I call the trauma of being a perpetrator. I would say, and this is my experience, every person that has been made a victim of trauma ends up in being a perpetrator of trauma, doing something to others that traumatizes us. So, this is the trauma biography. This is how it is. And this is what I think has to be named. Without feeling guilty, without feeling shamed, without feeling unnormal, because only if you see this truth, what trauma does to us, and how we reproduce trauma, how we, from one generation to the next, give over trauma to the next generation, only then we do have a chance to step out.